Listen.
I have been involved in an accident 5 times. If it hadn't been for the Lord on my side, where would I have been? He's been my lawyer. He's been my provider. He's been my judge. He's been my nurse. He's been my doctor. When I'm not faithful, he is faithful.
Yeah.
Yeah.
is good. And all the time, please give a wave offering unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Wasn't it beautiful to see all the big giants in the ministry all on one platform lifting the name of the Lord higher? For the past 2 days, the enemy wanted me to stay in bed. You can hear from the sound of my voice. Because I told the devil that I am here to bring my fragrance of worship unto him. And therefore he did not want this day to come to pass. We have been through trials in the past 2 days. The enemy did everything. But at the last hour, the Lord said, Nana, I have approved this occasion. And everything began to fall in place. Tonight, from the bottom of my heart, I want to say thank you to all of you. I cannot mention names. Those who travel all the way from Ghana. One of my spiritual fathers, Reverend Estuo Mensah, landed this evening from Ghana. He said, Nana, I'm going to be here. I salute you. Amen. I want to also thank the father of the house, Reverend Stephen Esifua, and the first lady. It's been an honor and a blessing to be here. Hallelujah. All the pastors, all the singers, may the Lord richly bless you all. I believe that with Reverend Mark Asantimenu here, maybe we can organize an 8 hours worship marathon. 12 hours. Amen. We'll be working on it. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord laid a burden on my heart, and I want to share with you. As soon as I am done sharing, I will hand over the microphone to Pastor Mark for a very special message. Also, I was in Ghana. I don't know if Edinam is here. Edinam Kujo, if you are here, you can join me here. I was in Ghana not too long ago, and I'm involved in a village outreach project, and I visited a village, and they don't have good drinking water. The health infrastructure in that village is very poor. So I said, every birthday gift that I get tonight is going to go and drill a borehole in Ghana. Amen. I believe that if we go to share the word of God and somebody needs water, you just don't walk away. You provide them with water and also give them the word of God. Amen. So I have a couple of nurses that we want to travel, God willing, every year. We will start next year and go and teach simple first aid and CPRs. We want to give back to our community. We want to give back to our nation, Ghana. I saw some schools that people should not live in those walls. And they say life begins at 40. And as I am a newly born, this evening, that is my goal and my vision. I believe that you can help me out. I will send you information on our first borehole that we will be drilling. Next year, God willing, I will be going back. I was in Ghana. I spent 10 days not too long ago, and we did a lot of stuff together with the team that Minister John Senna has put together. They do village outreach, and I'm partnering with them. We want to go to the villages and support. On a day like this, every birthday gift can put simple shoes, simple clothing on the back of our most unfortunate ones back home in Ghana.